Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another edition of Verses and Flow. It feels so good to be here. Yet another week of fantastic poetry that we have here for you. So just stay tuned. What we're going to do is mix it up a little bit from what we've had the last time at our arrival show and some bits and pieces from Kamadia's live show. So stay tuned, relax and enjoy. Don't you go anywhere. Verses and Flow is here right now.
Creator divine, I give thanks and praises for your love, your patience, your greatness. Leave traces, displaces hate, fills empty spaces with love, amazes the hosts of heaven above. A God of all races, he's love, all cases he solves. Around you life revolves, my world evolves, delivering from whatever places I call, leaving my spirit appalled, turning great problems small, helping me up when I fall. I give thanks and praises for your love, your patience, your greatness. Who's complaining about life? Your mind's maintaining your vice, refraining to fight, thoughts containing fright, alienated from light, mistaken day for night. You better give thanks and praises for his love, his patience, his greatness, separating knowing from believing, captivating my being, illuminating my being, accelerating my freedom. He is the reason I live. The reason I forgive, the reason I cry, the reason I try, the reason I dance, the reason I prance, the reason I plan, the reason I can, he is the reason I am. So yes, I give thanks and the praises for his love, his patience, his greatness. Who's contemplating letting go? Concentrating on ego, taking highs to low, creating evo, stagnating growth, pacing to and fro. How long hold ye between two opinions? Making bad decisions, disrupting God's missions, corrupting others' visions, using religion to imprison. When I talk, you listen. I speak with precision, defining his love, make my flows deficient, my verbs malnutrition. He breaks down walls, mountains standing tall. At his presence, mountains fall, answers whenever I call. He is my all, so yes, I give thanks and praises for his love, his patience, his greatness. He blows my mind. He's the reason I chose to rhyme. He's pros, no cons. So yes, I give thanks and praises for his love, his patience, his greatness.
He said, "Who is at my door?" I said, "Your humble servant." He said, "What business do you have?" I said, "To greet you, O Lord." He said, "How long will you journey on?" I said, "Until you stop me." He said, "How long will you boil in this fire?" I said, "Until I am pure." This is the oath of love. For the sake of love, I gave up wealth and position.
Thank you.
He said, "You have pleaded your case, but you have no witness." I said, "My tears are my witness. The pallor on my face is my proof." He said, "Your witness has no credibility. Your eyes are too wet to see." I said, "By the splendor of your justice, my eyes are clear and faultless." He said, "What do you seek?" I said, "To have you as my constant friend." He said, "What do you want from me?" He said, "I want your abundant grace." He said, "Who was your companion on this journey?" I said, "The thought of you, O King." He said, "What called you here?" I said, "The fragrance of your wine." He said, "What brings you the most fulfillment?" I said, "The company of the Emperor." He said, "What do you find there?" I said, "100 miracles. He said, "What? Why is the palace deserted?" I said, "They all fear the thief." He said, "Who is the thief?" I said, "The one who keeps me from you." He said, "Where is their safety?" I said, "In service and renunciation." He said, "What is there to renounce?" I said, "The hope of salvation." He said, "Where is their calamity?" I said, "In the presence of your love." He said, "How do you benefit from this life?" I said, "By keeping true to myself." Now it's time for silence. If I told you about his true essence, you would fly from yourself and be gone. I neither door nor roof could hold you back. Thank you very much.
It's all a lie. Beneath their charades, the insipid things we concede to. Is this how we were made? If only birds flapping their wings in opposition could speak. If only they could sanction a people so weak. But yet we stand all along pretending as though their costumes that are mounted for public admirations are authentic. But if only you know that there is no firm foundation on which these admirable qualities stand. But yet we judge by appearance. How can we esteem based upon the apparels that adorn the mere coverings of their treacherous souls? You see, the nucleus of our failures inextricably tied to our inability to delve beneath the epidermis of a stranger's character. So because I come dressed in fine clothing and speak words that sound as though I'm clairvoyant, I'm automatically elevated to the status of a deity. Now due to my instantaneous elevation on a pedestal, my every utterance is declared divine. This is the painful revelation of our feeble-mindedness. For all the while, visionaries, prophets, and great men are dwelling within our midst. But it's anyone's guess the extent of their recognition. Yep, a continuous cause though. But false prophets are revered for dressing in fine suits and regurgitating ideas long established by great men, all the while making their utterances sound as though due to exhaustive study novel ideas have surged into their minds. But I've lived and learned too much to accede to such mendacity. You see, greatness comes not dressed in the finest of clothing. With greatness, there's simplicity, not heavy duplicity and a continuous thirst for publicity. That's why we frequently fall prey to our own apathy. Then we want to stage protests after we realize we are the victims of trickery. Suddenly we recognize that we want to be free. Now we want to stamp out what has become the nucleus of our existence. Now we are fighting, raging protests and putting up resistance as if what we are faced with is a situation totally alien to us. As if its existence was never passage through the course of time. As if our impropriety is in no way responsible for the germination of these false prophets. As if their existence is a social phenomenon way beyond human comprehension. When all the while we were the ones harboring and nourishing them, feeding their overcompensating egos. Now that their impropriety has become a gargantuan problem, now that it is directly contributing to our mayhem, we shy away and play and disown our own creation. When all the while we could have nipped this catastrophe in its infantile stages. Why couldn't we have recognized greatness in our presence? Why are we forever seeking something afar off to reverence? See, our actions are like the children of Israel who had to pass through hell just to realize all the while they were well. 40 years in the wilderness due to an obscure vision, looking for something new when all they needed was revision. A simple introspection could have charted them on the right path, but no, they had to endure God's wrath. Then a changed people was the aftermath. So people, I implore you, instead of wasting precious time, energy, and resources looking for persons that are imbued with idyllic characteristics, instead of chasing your utopia, get with reality and start embracing the geniuses that are brewing right within your midst.
All right, so that was just the first installment. Please don't move. We'll be right back after these short messages.